I started playing spoons because they were easy, easier than playing guitar, playing drums. It wasn't as easy as singing, and I like that. I preferred that better, but it was easy.
I met artists in 1971.
I first saw him at the Pike Place Market, like so many other people. And I think it was before I even moved to Seattle. I saw this guy slapping these spoons on his cheek, and I was like, who's this guy? A pretty interesting guy.
Well, once I became a teenager, I was a pretty bad boy. I did some thievery and vandalism, and I joined the Navy rather than from jail, actually, when I was 17 on my 17th birthday, and I spent a couple of years in jail. Well, it's like jail, the Navy. Hung myself, actually. I was cut down unconscious, discharged with an honorable discharge, and went to work for the post office about a year later. Worked at the post office for a couple of years. Our daughter was born while I was there. And then I started playing spoons in a cafe and then some bars.
I remember playing a band break in a little place called the Medicine Show Tavern, and he was in the audience, and he asked me if he could play with me, and he just kind of looked like, this will be interesting. You look like an interesting character. Yeah, let's just try this out. I didn't know what to expect, but it was very energetic and very cool, and that's the first time that I remember meeting him.
I got to know artists first just from being a performer at the Pike Place Market. But when I really got to know him was when I was working at the Folklife Festival as the program director. And I called artists one day and I said, how would you like to be part of our winter concert where we raise money for the Folklife Festival? And he graciously agreed to perform for free for our concert where we raised money. So that's really how I got to know him. And after that, we just were close and had a good relationship.
Frank Zappa's the only major artist that I pursued. I got in touch with him by being introduced to him at a meet and greet in Portland, 1981. I played for him. He offered to get me on TV. Then I closed the show for him 4 days later in Eugene, Oregon. And I closed the show for him a month later in New York at the Palladium. How'd I get in contact with Soundgarden? Well, actually, Soundgarden got in contact with me. You see, I really don't pursue much. I never thought to pursue a grunge act. I was already just about 50. I mean, I wouldn't even think to contact them. They were all 30. Yeah, it is something to be encouraged by. I was very encouraged because I rocked. I could rock. Working with them on stage was wow. I mean, really wow. Especially Matt Cameron. My goodness, doesn't he play? But and of course, the whole band. Of course, no reason. I mean, no wonder they're global.
I thought it was fantastic. I was pleased for Frank Zappa and Soundgarden that they discovered him, and pleased for artists that he had been discovered.
What I think about publicity is that it comes with the it's part and parcel of the vocation or the lifestyle, the trade.
I mean, when Soundgarden was doing their thing and he was going down to the studio in LA to record with them, he'd leave and go down there and then come back and play at the Pike Street Market with me. So he never stopped doing it. And if you ask him about what street performing is, he's got a rap already already memorized, and he'll go on for like 5 or 6 minutes about it. And he's right. It's a real thing, you know?
Well, I think if artists had really wanted to get more recognition, he would have gone after it. I think sometimes when I've talked to him, he's been disappointed that things haven't worked out at the level that he hoped they would work out. So, you know, I don't know what's happened to artists in terms of his career. I mean, he had a kind of international exposure at a certain point, but where was he going to take that? It's hard to know.
Where am I living? I'm living in a two-room flat overlooking the Bay of Port Townsend. I have never lived in a more luxurious place. You know, I mean, it's a two-room flat. It's subsidized by the state. I pay $200. I get $700 a month from SSI and Social Security. And, you know, I struggle financially. But hey, I've always struggled financially.
I don't play that much with artists anymore. We fed each other's rock and roll drive, you know, and after a while it was like there was so much more that I wanted to do that wasn't the rock and roll. I mean, we really had a blast. I mean, I did anyway. I think he did too. I really, really, really appreciate the work that we did over those years, but the course just changed, you know. Yeah.
I think artists are special because he does work outside of the box. I mean, and he's a little frightening to some people, you know? There's a kind of an edge to artists, the Spoon Man. I mean, the first time I saw him slapping his cheeks with those wooden spoons, I was like, are you hurting yourself? So I think he pushes the edge just a little bit for people, and that's the other reason he's really special.
Good. Good.